So this is showing the ultrasound image in the corner. So he's holding the ultrasound beneath him. And we're trying to kind of point him to what is this part of the image represent.
The field of speech pathology is still pretty young. I mean, there's a lot that we don't know about how people talk. It's a really complicated thing that involves, you know, memory and language and muscle control and the brain. And our field is still in its infancy right now.
So this is me talking now with the ultrasound. So t, t. And then there are sounds that we use the back of our tongue for, like g, g, g. So you see that part raising and lowering.
The type of treatment that we're doing now is for children who have articulation disorders. So the kids that we work with are children who have difficulty with the R sound. So those are kids who sometimes if they're not pronouncing sounds correctly, they can be hard to understand. They can be teased, they can be bullied, they can be picked on because their speech isn't quite clear. If a child is saying lead instead of red, we can try to teach them, oh, when you make that first sound, you've got to lift the front of your tongue up a little bit more and pull the back of your tongue down a little bit more. And typically in speech therapy, that's a very abstract concept when we try to tell people what to do with their mouth. Most of us don't have a good understanding of what's happening when we're producing speech. But with an ultrasound, it gives us a visual display of what's happening. We can provide very concrete instructions about, I want this part of your tongue to move over here, and I want that part of your tongue to go there. And our clients can see if they're actually achieving that or not. For a lot of kids, we sort of pitch it to them like it's a video game. So, you know, there's a screen and we'll sometimes draw over the screen. We'll just put a little dot and say, I want you to try to hit this dot with the front of your tongue. So then they can see whether they've done that or not.
Oh.
So you see how your tongue is pretty flat,
mm-hmm.
right? Can you try to drop down the middle? Keep the sides elevated. Dr. Preston, there it is.
Yep, there it is. That's it.
That's it.
Every student in speech-language pathology is required to complete some observation of therapy before they start their clinical training. So there's a website called masterclinician.org that many speech-language therapy students across the country will access videos to watch assessment and treatment sessions that are recorded. And since we've had a lot of inquiries about what our treatment's like, and it's sort of nebulous to people who don't know anything about the use of ultrasound in speech therapy, even people who've been working in the field for 25 or 30 years don't really know what it's like to use ultrasound in speech therapy. So we wanted a way to try to get examples out there to show people what our treatment is like.
Yeah. Give me a sentence with truth.
We always want to be careful in our field as clinicians and as researchers, we have competing interests. So as clinicians, everybody wants what's new and they want to try this new therapy. As researchers, we want to make sure that we're testing to be sure that this type of treatment really is effective before we tell everybody that they should go out and use this type of treatment. It's not a miracle cure. Our goal is for ultrasound to be one option for treatment for clients who have speech difficulties, but it's not the only option.